Come on, let's hear it out now. Ooh. We've got once again Piggy Eaters, another real time battle by Rocky Waswani. So, do we have Piggy Eaters at home? We do? Can we know about them?
I think that's why I'm sitting over here, because I'm surrounded by Piggy Eaters. They all have they're all a pain in the ass. Sorry.
We'll chop that out.
They are very, very difficult, and I am constantly trying to cater to their likes and dislikes. One fine day, I got frustrated and fed up, and I said, "That's it." And that's when I got in touch with this lovely lady, and I said, "You gotta help me. I really don't know how to constantly please these men in my life over here." So that's when she jumped to the rescue, and ever since then, those picky eaters are now they're happy, and they're like groveling at my feet because I'm constantly cooking some good food for them. So thank you so much for helping me. But I think being a picky eater is not wrong. It's not a bad thing, because I think that means you are a very discerning palate, and you want to learn more. You want to taste good food. You want to experience good food and an eating experience. So that's why you have picky eaters.
My kitchen, just my description about my kitchen. My kitchen, my safe haven. My kitchen is my paradise. I could have a high fever, but I would still wake up and go to work. At home, I'm relaxed when I cook, and therefore it's in those moments that I brainstorm and try to think of new ideas and explore new types of cuisines. I love finding quick methods of cooking and taking shortcuts, because if you have a picky eater, you do need to do that as well. I like to keep my kitchen workstation absolutely clean. That feels like it's inviting me to create some more. I love the sizzle of butter in the pan, marriage of butter and garlic. I think that's a big high. So it's a match made in heaven. The smell of freshly baked bread. It's very therapeutic to knead your own dough and then wait for those beautiful creations that come out, and then they are absolutely massacred by some hungry beast. I love a busy kitchen with everyone running in all directions.
The last line was the most entertaining one. I like, yeah, this is a book, but go buy it. That's the part. You go buy it. You have to buy it.
You have to buy a book.
Alright, so now what we've got some random questions for everybody. Alright, so let's just start with that.
Okay.
So I want you to give some reactions to the things that I say. Alright? Broccoli.
Love it.
Palak.
Yuck.
Kaddu.
Buttu.
We got tendli.
I love tendli sabzi.
You love tendli? How you know tendli? We thought only we Marwadis know tendlis.
I know, ask any sabzi and I'll
tell you. Really? You, okay, give me five super desi names of sabzis.
Tinda.
Whoa. That's from Malaika, so is that like tinda?
Bengan, Gawar, Sua.
I'm not liking you looking at me two times and she's like, Gawar,
Gawar, Gawar.
Looking right at me like, Gawar, Gawar.
I sound like I'm abusing you right now, right?
That's the feel about desi sabzis, you know. The karela kha le, tu tinda kha, aaj tu palak le, tu baith rahe yahan pe. That's so cool.
Did I win my raspa?
Yeah, you did, and you win a book.
Before you move on, I just want to say that sitting over here is a dream come true for me. I mean, one would think I have to, sitting on a film set or being, the way we are perceived, that is what really excites me, but this is what excites me. Sitting among really amazing chefs and people who know their food, I think nothing better than that. I think that's the biggest turn on for me. And I have to admit that some days back, I was reading about you. So I was so excited just now when I saw you. I was going through some of your articles and your recipes and stuff. stuff, and I was like, wow. And then here you are standing in front of me. I was like, oh. I almost jumped up and wanted to ask you for your autograph, and then I stopped myself. So I'm really, really, really excited. I feel like I'm in a candy shop right now. So excuse me if I do kind of overreact, but that's how I feel right now. And you as well, Kunal. You know I love you. I love you for years. I've known you too long, and I love you. I love your sense of craziness and your dedication to food. I love you for that.
So if you were to relate Mr. Kunal to one of the sabzis, what would that be?
Bopla.
No, what's that?
First of all, this one.
You know, the way you just turned around and you look so sweet, I was like, ye to khane wali feel aa rahi hai, ye to let's just ask.
But I think it's so sweet because, you know, Bhopla is so underrated, it's so cute, it's so sweet, and it's a lovely vegetable.
I agree with
you. It's amazing. And you can do it. It's not only that, it's very versatile. It works in Indian cuisine as well as European. Chef, you have to agree, it works in European as well as Indian cuisine. It's very versatile. So true.
It's lovely, shiny, orange, soft inside. And much like me. Yes, Bhopla. Thank you, Malaika.
Thank you. So we got another name today. Bhopla.
That's it now. My name's changed.
It's changed. Kunal Bhopla Vijaykar. Alright, so coming to you. What's your favorite food?
My favorite food? And the only green thing that I really, really like is green peas. So it's meat, potatoes and green peas in any form.
Okay, how about imagine this now. You're put in a room, yeah, like some Big Boss scenes, yeah? You're put in a room with vegetarians for 2 months. There is no non-veg food.
But I'm going to tell you about this Big Boss thing. About 4 or 5 years ago, I got a call from somebody, production company, and they said, will you be part of Big Boss? Okay. It wasn't as vile as it has become now. So I asked them only one question. I said, you answer this question for me and we will discuss that. So I said, will I get non-veg food at Big Boss or not? They could not answer my question. They didn't know. They're still trying to figure it out, you know. Never called me back after that.
Oh, ek phone aaya tha mujhe. Main aaj tak figure out kar raha hu. Alright, coming to you, Radhika. Okay, let's talk about... Okay, no serious questions at all. What's your favorite food, firstly?
I love fish.
You love fish? And how about Shan? What does he like?
Bengali fish.
Okay, very good. So, made for each other type. Say, so how about your kids now? What do they like? Are they like picky eaters? They trouble you a lot?
Actually, so much you were at a given point where I used to, you know, when they were small, they could not eat anything. So I had developed this great idea of taking a mixer, putting in roti, sabji, dal, churning it, taking a mixed food and shoving it into their mouth. But eventually now, of course, I mean, Soham is like 13 and this, so now they eat everything. I've just tried to make, you know, the environment. The thing is, you know, as Bengalis, we don't believe in wasting anything in the house.
Okay.
So after, you know, I've deboned the fish and all of that, we have to keep the bones separate because in the morning, my mother-in-law would tell me, wo dal mein bhigo ke, wo taste aa jayega, phir kaate nikal dena. I said, but mom, you know, dal is vegetarian, she said, kisi ko pata bhi nahi chalega, de de.
That is true. There's a fish bone chorchery that they make in Kolkata. Just the spine of a big Rahu. And you can just go on at it for hours because you just go at the marrow and then go on at it. It's insane.
So just
Gujarati and I've gone to
who's the Gujarati so there? We are everywhere.
So we had gone to Ahmedabad and I told the kids, you know, I said, see, there's dal bhat roti shak. You're not going to get any non-veg here. They said, okay, no problem, mom. So the food came. So mom is looking at the curry and saying, but where is the shark tail, mama? So I said, oh God, I mean shark as in a Gujarati vegetable. It's not a shark. Yeah.
But yeah, I got into this early curtsy cooking at Langer's, which I was forced into. And then, moved on. Cooked on the streets.
So what was your favorite lunchbox item? Like, what would you tell your mom to cook for you every day for your lunch?
My favorite lunchbox item was the guy sitting next to me is lunchbox.
Oh, where your mom always cooks, you know, thoda tikhi. It's yeah. The other one's mom who's always better.
So that's what my mom is always upset about. Like, sab chef bolte hai, main, you know, I wanted to cook like my mom, my inspiration is my mom. You never say that. I was like, yeah, because I always like the lunchbox the next sitting, the guy sitting next to me got. Like,
that's
my fault.
That's brutal. That makes me
a picky eater.
The crispy ones with the raw onions. Yum.
How about you, karelas? No.
That's how we make it. Fried karela with curd.
And finally, Raki, how about curd? No, you don't want this.
It's gonna come as a surprise, but I hate karela. I've been a picky eater myself. So my mom knows I never ate karela. Till date, whenever we do our Mughlai class and we do the tawa sabzi, you know. So I try to avoid not to make the karela there also. So, but yeah, I mean, when it's fried and crispy, it's amazing with all that tawa masala. That's the only preparation I like. But otherwise, I would run away from it most of the time.
I am getting this book to my mom. Bachpan se mujhe ek hi karela khilaya gaya tha. I didn't know there's a South Indian now. So how many types are there?
So luckily for me, I was a picky eater always, I said. So I used to go into the kitchen myself. When I used to hear kya lunch pe kya banaya hai, singhi aloo. That's another thing. Aaj main doodhi drumstick ka soup rose peeti hu. I make it tasty. But singhi aloo I used to never like. So I remember going
but
into
there
the
has
kitchen.
To be there has to be a complete conversation.
Yeah, we have somebody right very
you cannot just
mom,
close this
my
one.
Mom.
Hamari singhi aloo ke bare mein baat ho rahe hain. Aapki vishesh tippani dijiye. Okay, now I leave it people here. Do you have some questions? Do you have some questions?
Yeah.
All right, there. Let's just keep the question to the book and that's it.
Can I ask you one question,
ma'am? Yeah, sure.
Anyway, first of all, I want to thank you to you. Ask one question. I hope you don't mind. You won't fire me after that.
I will think about it. Just ask me the question.
See, your name is Malaika Arora. I've always met in many programs, but I could not get muster my courage to speak to you. You always been in Gillette and all, shaving and all. So now your name is Malaika Arora. It's a very good name. But your name is Malaika Arora. So are you made of Malaya or what? Because you always look beauty and all. So.
Thank you very much. How can I ever get angry with what you have said? It's not possible. So that's very sweet. That's
she always looks sweet like Malaika only. Because I've seen her so many years from Chhaiya Chhaiya and all. Still you look same. So what sir, is the secret of your
sir? आप book से छाया छाया से अभी आप बचपन में चले जाएंगे. I love your smile, yaar. Oh, killer! Thank you so much. Thank you.
How sweet! Thank you very much. I think that's the sweetest compliment. Thank you.
I love the way you were only talking. You're telling him कि आपकी बीवी कितनी अच्छी सर. आपके घर पे इतनी problem है. मतलब हमारे घर पे इतना recession आ गया अभी. Hi sir, thank you so much. Thank you so much, sir. Thank you. Anybody else who wants to ask some questions? Oh, hello sir.
Rekha ji, Rajinder Singh from Makrana. Mein. Aapne itne achhi book likhi hai, to aapko knowledge.
Thank you so much for that.
So why don't you write another books also? जो आपको ज्ञान हो जिस चीज का आपको talent है आपके अंदर ऐसा कोई नहीं सोचता.
हाँ तो ये first है. Of course इसके बाद और लिखना है. डेफिनेटली पहले इसको आप सराहिए रीड कीजिए इसको आप बेस्ट सेलर बनाइए रेसिपीज ट्राई कीजिए रिमेम्बर आई वांट पीपल टू गो बैक एंड मेक द रेसिपीज
दूसरे सब्जेक्ट में आप घूम जाते हैं आप लिखें कुछ और
दूसरे सब्जेक्ट डेफिनेटली आई वांट टू बट इसकी भी हम सीरीज बनाने वाले हैं फॉर श्योर सो इसे आप पहले बेस्ट सेलर बनाइए एंड वी आर वर्किंग ऑन अनदर बुक एज़ वेल
इस बुक में रणबीर जी का बाकी जो शेफ हैं इनका क्या कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन आपके
इनका हमारा इनकी गुड विशेस हैं मेरे साथ वो मेरे इंडस्ट्री में हैं साथ में कलीग हैं सो ऑब्वियसली वी नीड दैट सारे वेल विशर्स हैं
खाने का कनेक्शन बहुत होता है सर हम सबका भी खाने का ही कनेक्शन है ना दैट्स मोर देन एनफ फूड कनेक्ट्स एवरीबॉडी
यस
सर ऐसे कपड़े सोनम के अलावा कौन पहनता है सर स्टाइलिस्टा
बिल्कुल बिल्कुल सही कहा आपने सर
थैंक यू
सलमान भाई थैंक यू